The pressure exerted by the atmosphere is 14.70 pounds per square inch. What is the pressure expressed in kilograms per squared meter? Okay, so first we're going to take 14.70 pounds per square inch. So we need to have kilograms in the numerator remaining and square meter in the denominator, right? Because per means that there's a division. Okay, so first we're going to convert pounds to kilograms, right? Because that's the weight. So we will need to have pounds on the bottom and kilograms on the top, right? So we know that 2.205 pounds take up 1 kilogram. Okay, so that's good. The pounds are over with. Now we need to convert square inches into square meter, right? So the square inches will be on the top and square meter will be on the bottom as exactly needed by the denominator, right? So square inches. So we know, how do we relate inches and meters? We know that 1 meter takes 39.37 inches. But we need to square, right? Because we have a square inch. So we square everything. So if you square the top, you can square individual parts, the number and the unit. That's fine, right? Because that's mathematically allowed, right? The properties of exponents that you should be aware of. Now the bottom will also be squared, right? So 1 squared is 1 and meter squared is, you just put a 2 there, right? So now you're ready to cancel these out, right? So the inches squared will be canceled out. So you can now deal with the numbers using your calculator. So let's see what that's going to be. 14.7 divided by 2.205 times 39.37 squared. Okay, so what I'm getting is this: 10,333.31267, my calculator. Now there are 4 significant figures, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So so 4 significant figures, so we start from left to right, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So this is the one we round to, and this one is 3, the next one, so that means the 3 stays. So it can be rounded like this, 330, okay? Now, the only thing, how would you express that in scientific notation? You realize that the zero to the right of the non-zero is important still, right? So you can express it as 1.033, because you need 4 significant figures, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4. Times 10 to which power? So if we place the decimal after the 1, how many times do we shift it to get to the right of the 0? That's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? So the power should be to the 4th. And don't forget the units. That's going to be kilograms per squared meter. Thank you for watching. Hope this was helpful, and I'll see you in the next video.